好的，欢迎回来。您正在收看和收听的是由判断 TV 37和 FM 90.6正在为您同步直播的《朝闻天下》，我是主持人叶文。
大家早上好，我是小娇。就在这短短的可能是几分钟的时间，大家可以看到我们的整个直播间的样子已经变了。我们现在呢，仿佛是去到了异国他乡来感受啊。
没错，我现在整个这个直播室里面啊，闻到的味道啊是完全不一样的，很香啊，各种香气非常的弥漫。
那么今天呢，我们是非常的开心，再次是请到了 Snowberry 的创始人 Soraya 女士是来到我们的节目当中，但是今天我们说到的不是她的宝贝 Soraya，不是她的宝贝 Snowberry，而是我们要说到的是一种啊，也算是在新西兰这边可能大家有见到但是不太了解的波斯文化。
没错，我们先请 Soraya 跟大家打个招呼啊。So Clip is first say hi to our audience.
Hi, it's wonderful to be here. First of all, I just wanted to offer my condolences to the wonderful Chinese New Zealanders for last Friday's tragedy, but life must go on, and we are here to exchange cultures and better understanding of each other's cultures, and we are part of one nation, so it is good to celebrate that.
And also, it's just the right time we can talk about different cultures in New Zealand.
Very timely. Thank you, Panda.
Thank you, and thank you, Soraya. So first of all, can you just tell us where are you originally from?
Yes, I was born in Tehran. The new name is Iran, of course, but personally I prefer Persia because the language is Persian, the Persian carpet is quite famous, and the history is amazing, like the Chinese, you know, we've got thousands of years of history, and it is, that is where I was born, and I was, you know, it's exactly like a Thousand and One Nights country.
Yeah.
And there is so many, anything you touch is thousands of years old, and the culture is amazing.
Yeah.
And so I grew up with wonderful stories about the past, and you know, how that land became, you know, what it is today.
Yeah. So are you like your family all originally from, you know, the same kind of culture, same
Yes. I left Tehran when I was about 13, 14 years old, and I grew up all over the world, but you know, I have a lot of respect for the Persian culture and where I'm from.
Right.
So it is wonderful to be here and explain.
Yeah, well, the everything just, you know, display our table. It's just so beautiful. But let me explain, like translate a little bit to our audience first. 所以首先呢，今天要稍微跟大家来啊做一个这个应该说是简单的介绍。
是的。
那么 Soraya 呢，其实他是出生在伊朗的。那么他自己呢是比较喜欢说这是一个波斯的国家，或者是说呢波斯文化的一个国家。
没错。
那么他大概是在13、14岁左右，然后呢是离开了伊朗，那么接下来呢就在世界各地啊都有生活过。
没错，我们也知道啊，其实在现在的当今的这个叫做伊朗的这个国家啊，当然现在当今的伊朗的这个地区呢，其实也是波斯文化最盛行的一个地区。其实呢，在当地这种文化也是流传了上千年的历史了，
是的，
有非常浓厚的这种文化的底蕴。包括啊，其实在当地的这个文化，当地你能看到的这些建筑啊，能尝到的这些美食啊等等一系列的啊，体验到的风土人情，其实都有千年的历史。
那么刚才呢，泽尔也说到说，正好呢是在我们知道悲剧刚刚结束，那么在这个时候呢，正好是我们啊可以忘记仇恨，但是呢去共同的去了解互相的文化。那么再借着这个契机呢，能够借助我们的平台也是跟大家来介绍波斯文化，是他非常非常开心的一件事情、啊、
没错，现在这个时间点非常的合适、
So what is the like the key thing for the Persian culture? It's like, you know, what is the main difference from other cultures?
Well, each culture, of course, they've got their own traditions.
Yes.
And there is a lot of, well, Persians were originally Zoroastrians. It's a very ancient religion.
Yes.
And it was very simple, pure and simple. They said to do well, to think well, and to talk well. And that's it, basically. If you are a person who does good things and talks, says good things, it's just very basic and everyone will be fine.
Right.
So I think that's the basic of, and in fact, actually, I've been recently to Vatican, and they were telling me about the Mithraism statue that was there in Vatican, which is a Persian statue, ended up in Vatican, and they said that it was the origin of all the religions, and it was a secret religion. Romans acquired it from Persians, and they were just by shaking hands, they talked to each other. Just it was a secret religion.
Really?
Just by shaking hands, they knew that each other.
Oh,
wow. Yes, so
they must have a different way to shaking hands.
Yes, I don't know how, you know, it was ended up there, but it was fascinating for me. But
yeah.
Persians were Zoroastrians, mm-hmm. and they worship fire. Fire is quite an important element for us.
Mm.
Mm.
And still today, there are fire temples there.
Ooh.
And the basis of the New Year, the Persian New Year, is based on foundations and based on the Zoroastrian, you know, way of thinking.
Mm.
For example, we grow wheat grass because it gives you the, you know, like new. It's a sign of renewal,
oh,
rebirth,
yes.
and renewal.
Mm. Right.
There are a lot of things about, you know,
the New Year culture.
Yes, forgetting the bad past and renew and regenerate.
It's similar to our Chinese culture,
yes.
as well. For the Chinese New Year, we can talk about the New Year later on. Let me just translate that part. 刚才啊，我们就提到说，我说那在波斯文化当中有什么比较特殊的地方？当然，我们知道每一个文化嘛都有自己的特殊性，但是它最，比如说集中的，或者说它最大的特点是什么？那么我刚才听到 Sarah 她自己也说，她说其实他们的这个民族呢，如果要说波斯的这个整个的民族和文化，其实也是非常简单的，他们就有点类似于像我们说你做好人，
对，
好好
说
话，说
好话，
对，然后呢，
做好事，
做好事就可以过一个比较开心的、幸福的人生。其实他们呢
是
也是啊，追求类似的，但是他就说，因为啊，波斯文化和我们中国文化一样，都是有着上千年、上万年的这样的一个历史，所以有很多神秘的地方呢，也是后人啊，可能都是在逐渐发掘当中的。他就举例，他说他去梵蒂冈看到那个雕塑，他说人家说这个雕塑就是波斯文化的遗物的那种感觉，
对，好像始祖的感觉、啊，
哎，对，然后呢，他们就聊天，就说他们其实啊，就互相也有自己的这种宗教信仰，但是他这个宗教信仰呢，是一个神秘的宗教信仰。就他们之间啊，是你一握手，哎，他就知道你是
彼此能识别出自己的是同根同源的这种感觉。
对，
所以这个也是很神奇的一件事情啊。
那么在波斯文化当中呢，他们比较就像我们在中国文化当中会有自己的像一个神明啊，或者是说呢会有自己的一些信仰。在波斯文化当中，他们是非常崇敬或者是说是敬畏火这个东西的。他们很多的文化呀，包括食物呀，包括庆祝的一些方式啊，都是围绕着火来进行的。
没错。那么包括在如今呢，其实在伊朗，在波斯的整个文化中啊，也还有很多这种跟火相关的寺庙呀等等一些的这种也算是大家祭拜的一些地方吧。
嗯，
其实都是跟传统是相关的。
是的。
而且也包括啊，其实我们在台子上现在也能看到他们其实会种这种植物。我们叫它
就 green干，我觉得好像应该叫就是类似像韭菜呀、啊、或者是葱这样的一个东西。
没错，它就寓意着啊，说是新生，是每一年都会他们自己在家中去种的，或者说是这样的盆栽去供在自己的家这个桌子上的、啊、
其实它跟我们中国的文化很像，都是在 New Year 当中要去看一些新的东西，希望一个 new kind of 啊，对吧，一个新的一个欣欣向荣的这种感
觉，欣欣向荣啊，全新的一个开始啊等等，这样很好的一个寓意啊、
嗯、不过因为时间的关系啊，现在已经到了9:20了，我们稍作休息一下、
嗯、
回来之后呢，要让 Sora 给大家介绍介绍摆在桌子上面的这一些又究竟是什么呢。
好的，欢迎回来。您正在收看和收听的依然是由盼的 TV37 和 FM90.6 正在为您同步直播的朝闻天下，我是主持人依然。
大家早上好，我是小娇。今天早上我们非常非常开心啊，请到 Snowberry 的创始人 Soraya 女士是来到节目当中。今天呢，给大家介绍的是波斯的文化。我们现在整个直播间啊，真的是非常香
，smells so good
。So today we're gonna talk about a Persian's New Year, which is tomorrow.
Yes.It usually falls on the 20th or 21st of March.
Okay.
And it is basically Nowruz, which simply means the new day, a new day,、
yeah.
mm-hmm. is the Persian New Year.
So is it like different every year, or is
it basically falls on the 21st. How they calculate it is the beginning of the...spring equinox.
Oh.
The first day of the, it is exactly the same day, hour and minute of、
okay.
the spring equinox.、
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. When the day and night is exactly the same length.
Yes,、
mm.
yes.
So spring equinox is the when the Nowruz starts.、
Mm-hmm.
And 3 weeks, it's very similar to your culture you were talking about. Three weeks in advance, people prepare to what they call house shaking, which means house cleaning, getting rid of the dirt and dust and grime, because to give away the, you know, old dust and wait for the new beginning.
Yes.
And so after that, you will also see, if you go to Iran, a lot of Persian rugs washed and hung, you know, beautifully waiting for the new celebration.
Are you like buying new clothes? Because that's what we do
as well. Exactly. Yes. I haven't had a chance yet, but I would love to.
Yeah.
But yes, everyone, especially the children, we buy our children new clothes.
Mm-hmm.
And the last Tuesday night of the year, there is a fire festival, which is called Çarşamba Suri. Çarşamba in Persian means Wednesday. Suri means like a celebration, a red celebration.
Yeah.
And basically the last Tuesday night of the year, everyone sets fires, you know, bonfires, and there is, you know, fireworks, and people jump on the fire and chant a song. They say, زردی من از تو سرخی تو از من, meaning I give you my you know, pale color, and I want your beautiful red color. That and they jump over fire, you know, with the hope that all the bad things will be gone, and then a new beginning will arrive.
We have that too, but it's just not in the new year. We have a, like a thing that if you have some bad luck, you go cross the fire thing, then you will
Persians
get the luck.
Persians believe that.
So which was happened yesterday night, right?
Last night.
Last night. 所以我们先跟大家来说一下啊，这个波斯文化当中的新年真的是跟我们农历新年太像了。
对，有很多很相似的地方啊，他们也是在提。先跟大家来说啊，今年的这个波斯新年呢，就是会发生在明天。明天就是正式的这个波斯新年了啊。
那他们是怎么算的？像我们是农历嘛，每一年都不一样。那他们去怎么去计算的呢？其实就是我们知道这个春分，其实跟我们也是很像的。
是的。
就是他们的啊，这个冬日不是，应该说是白天和黑天完全平分。分的那一天就是他们的这个可以说是波斯的新年，所以你看跟我们的就是
很像，也是按照这个节气来算的，
也是按节气来算的。所以到了这一天，也就是今年啊，就是明天，他们呢就是波斯的新年了。但是他们还有一个什么传统呢？一个就是比如说提前3周要打扫房子，
没错，开始扫房子，然后开始洗衣服、洗床单、被罩啊等等，都开始清理了。那么也算是为了迎接新的一年啊。
还有他，我刚才在问他，我说那你们会不会买新衣服？他说也会，
当然也会，
就是在新年来之前，尤其是要给孩子要去购买新衣服，要换上新装。然后呢，到了这个每一个，就比如说啊，今天是比如说这个我们今天是已经到了星期三，他们会在周二，就是这一年算是农历，就我就说农历年啊，农历年的最后一个星期二，他们会有一个类似于像火节这样的一个
做法。没错，那么就是在昨天的晚上啊，那么就是这个传统的节日了。那么各家各户呢都会用上这种，比如说火的火把呀、火堆呀等等的，然后人呢是从这个火上面跳过去，
对，
然后寓意呢也是说希望啊把过去的一年的不好都给忘记，那么迎接新的一年。
其实这跟我们就是非常像，我刚才还跟他开玩笑说我们也有跨火盆，只不过我们的意义不太一样。那么在波斯文化当中，火是他们非常非常崇敬的，除了啊就说呢可能你会要跨过火盆或者是火堆，就寓意着你所有的不好的事情呢都会留在过去，新的一年的开始就是全新的开始。另外他们也会跳非常漂亮的那种火舞，如果大家有看过的朋友啊是很震撼的，他们拿着火把或者是说呢比如说像绳子呀什么的，上面全部都是火，然后呢就跳各种美丽的舞蹈。现在在看电视的朋友可以在画面上感受一下啊。
没错，是的。不过啊，这个跟关于这个波斯新年的东西啊，我相信有很多，我们桌上也是摆了非常多的这个吃的。
接下来我相信大家肯定想知道的就是关于吃，那么年夜饭要吃点什么呢？
是的。不过因为时间的关系啊，马上到了早上的9:30了，我们要稍作休息一下了，听几则商家有介绍。在一段广告回来之后啊，我们也会跟这个 Soria 女士啊继续来聊关于波斯的现在非常应景明年的新明天的这个新年啊，大家会用怎样的食物或者说怎样的小的传统的习俗来庆祝这个节日。我们稍作休息啊，广告回来之后跟大家接着聊。 好的，欢迎回来。您正在收看和收听的依然是由判断 TV 37和 FM 90.6正在为您同步直播的《朝闻天下》，我是主持人叶源。
大家早上好，我是小娇。那么回来啊，我们继续跟大家呢一同来了解波斯的这个非常让我觉得很美丽的一个文化啊。那么接下来刚刚呢就说到了关于波斯的新年，那么大门到底用什么样的方式去 celebrate 他们的新年呢？
So tomorrow will be the Persian New Year, right?
Yes.
So how do you celebrate it?
Well, the first thing is that we get together, you know, families get together, and they set this table up, which is consists of different things. They, in Persian, they start with, you have to put 7 things that start with S in Persian language.
Right.
Okay. For example, sabze is the...wheatgrass, which is a new beginning, rebirth. And there is senjed, which is the fruit of lotus flower, and the lotus tree, which is love. It's a sign of love.
Okay.
The spice samak there behind the fruit, I don't know if the viewers can see it, is because the color, it's red of the sunset.Sorry, it's the sunrise or sunset, but it is, in this case it is meant to be the sunrise. It's a new beginning.
All right.
And samanu is a like a pudding of the wheatgrass, and it is a sign of sweetness. Brings sweetness to your life.
Cool.
Seke, which is coins, is a sign of prosperity, to bring you wealth and prosperity.
Yes.
And there is in this little red jar, if you can see it, is serke, which is vinegar, means patience. You have to be patient.
Well, vinegar means patient.
Patience.
This is interesting.
Yes. Be patient.
Be patient.
Life. It's a good, patience is a virtue.
Yes,
exactly.
Because in Persian language, we have a lot, a Persian language is very poetic. We've got a lot of sayings, a lot of poetry.Poetry is huge in Persian. Rumi, Omar Khayyam, you know, there is lots of poets who were born in Persia and, you know, they've got books and we still today we enjoy their poetry. In fact, my mother is a member of the poetry group.
Wow.
And every, you know, week she goes to poetry and they, you know, say, talk about the poetry.
It's such a romantic culture.
It is. I must admit that one of my favorite poets is Hafez. You see the book, and every single Persian
one, right?
Has the book of Hafez. You can Google it if you want, and the poetry is amazing. He's a mystic poet, and it is just amazing, especially you know, Persians believe that whenever you want something and you are, you need some, like a mystic character to help you.
Yeah.
This is just like a belief.
Yeah.
You talk to Hafez and say, can you please tell me, you know, Hafez, what do you think? And they open it and the, apparently
the
Hafez, through poetry, will talk to you.
Wow.
You know, this is what we believe.
Right. We haven't finished those things on the table, so we haven't
the
talked
eggs,
about the eggs.
Colored, probably the, you know, it's interesting that Easter is coming and they also paint eggs, but this is thousands of years old, so maybe it's the origin. But it's a sign of fertility. And apple is a sign of beauty and health. And apart from this, we usually put goldfish, but...You can't because these days it's a, you know, animal rights.
Yes.
They don't keep it, which is okay. It is a sign of life, the goldfish.
All right.
And hyacinth, which is a sombol, it's a beautiful Persian flower.
Yeah.
Hyacinth is a sign of beauty and, you know, perfume.
So where do you put this? Just on the table?
Yes. You put it anywhere you like a decoration, like, you know, how...People put Christmas tree wherever you like. You put all of this, and you can decorate it as usual, as you like. Garlic seer is like medicine.
Oh, for your health.
Yes, for your health.
Yes.
Okay. So after finish, you know, celebration, are you going to eat those things? Or?
No, it sits there until the 13th day. 13 is like an unlucky number, they believe. And on the 13th day, everyone goes, they go for a picnic.
Yes.
And Ancient Persians were very environmentally friendly.
Yes.
You should not throw the wheat grass in the rubbish bin.
Mm-hmm.
You have to find a flowing river or somewhere to
flow them.
Mm-hmm.
But people who want to wish something, especially girls who want to find a nice husband, they tie the grass and say, oh, please, next year this time I'll have a nice man.
That's so cool. Oh my god. Let me translate.
Briefly,
yeah, briefly. 所以先跟大家说啊，我真的刚才听得很入迷，我现在很多朋友听得懂英文的应该就没有问题了。刚才就说到，其实呢这个啊摆在我们桌子上的，这就很像圣诞节的圣诞树。
没错。
他们会在家里边呢摆在任何的就是你想要摆
在家户户都会有这个特定的这个装置啊，就好像装饰品一样把它摆在自己家里面的桌子上。
是的。然后呢一般情况之下他们会放七种以上的这个东西。
是的。
然后呢每一种东西都要是 S 打头的，
没错，
这个也是还蛮有趣的，
在波斯语里面的
S 打头 的, 打头的、
啊、对。那么当然这每一种东西呢其实都有自己不同的寓意，我们举几个例子啊，比如说刚刚看到这个苹果，其实就是说是这个美丽啊，包括这个平安
平安啊
等等这些意思，包括我们放这个大蒜啊，他就说其实是跟身体健康这方面是有相
关的，它就很像说它是一种药来治愈你身体的不健康啊的地方。还有比如说鸡蛋是代表繁衍，
是
还有呢很多的这样像其他的一些地方像钱有coin 啊，当然是波斯语当中是 S 打头了啊，它呢就代表着比如说财富，像我们说还有一些比如说代表着新生，代表着明年呢有好运等等等等。
没错，而且啊，就根据这个习俗呢，是在新年的第十三天啊，因为十三在很多的文化中是不太吉
利
的数字啊。
嗯、
那么在第十三天的时候呢，就会把这些东西是他们会有一个 picnic， 就会有这种野餐吧，大家会一起出去啊，然后会按照当然也是保护环境的这个方面考量啊，不会吃这些东西，会把这些东西顺着这个流动的河流啊，水流呢是给它我们应该说让它随着水而冲走。
对，然后他就说呢，比如说啊，像那个我觉得像韭菜或者说叫葱叶子之类的，他们是代表着说新年的开始。很多的女孩子呢就会利用这个时间上面写一个小纸条啊，说哎，希望我明年可以找到男朋友啊之类的，找到老公
愿了啊，
然后系在上面，再顺着啊这个河流一起去流走。
我觉得这是很有意思的，文化的魅力真的很大啊。
So next one we are。I forgot to mention a thing about the poetry. We can talk more about that. So talk about the page, like the language. Do you think it's really like beautiful?
Oh, of course, of course. Persian is a very poetic language. And poetry is in our blood. And because we grew up with, you know, hearing about it, talking about it, and having it in every single celebration. And there is
you know how you do it? Do you sing like sing a song about
well,
the poetry?
Well, it's like when they read it, it's like quite it's like a melody. It's a beautiful melody. You know, it's like there is a nice tune to this when they read it.
Yeah.
And the meaning behind it, all Persians believe it's in their heart. Believe that they trust it. You know, like.I don't know if you know about Rumi, Omar Khayyam. And today the Persians, New Day Persians, they believe they were maybe saints because they knew so much about life, the wisdom. And thousands of years ago, hundreds of years ago, how did they know about life so well? How come they were so wise?
Yeah.
And it's amazing. And they talk about this life and, you know,that it is quite, you have to be true to yourself. You know, it's amazing.
So we have like Chinese, we have poetry too, but it's just in the ancient times.
Yes.
But nowadays we have some different kind of poetry, but how about Persian now? Do they have
poetry? Oh, we still, that still the ancient poetry still goes very strong.
Oh.
Very strong.
That's
even
a good thing.
Even sometimes in the street, there are people offering poetry in envelopes,and you give them a coin and you take and you wish something and you take an envelope and you read your future.
That's
amazing. That's
amazing.
Yes. 我们跟大家稍微来翻一下这件事情，我觉得这个是个很美好的也是很浪漫的事情啊。他就说呢，其实波斯的很多的语言啊，它也是以浪漫为基调的，它的当中有非常非常多的诗，这就像很像我们古代的我们的古诗一样的，只不过呢就是他们的这个诗的文化一直是保存到现在。现在你走在路上啊，或者这种古代的这样的一个诗仍然是在尤其像伊朗这样的国家所流行着。
没错，大家非常盛行啊，大家甚 至于可以直接在街头上面接到别人，比如说给到的信封里面就藏着一首诗，你可以拿到这首诗呢，就会让心情得到愉悦，或者让自己的这个烦恼消除，
就是有点像类似于像三个小命，大概就是看到抽到。
我觉得这是一个很好的文化的传承啊。
而且他们自己也说，他说他们就会觉得说这个诗哦，就像很多我们看古诗一样的，怎么会他们的前人是那么的 wise， 这么的就是
聪慧，
或者说他怎么知道那么多的事情？所以他们就类似于像他们这个诗啊，叫 Hafiz， 他就说
Hafiz，
就说很像是一种像那个，就是类似于像我们没事翻圣经。他说呢，就会啊，比如说许个什么愿，哎，你说我这件事情怎么办？然后他们就会打开这个诗啊，这本书，然后里边呢可能就会有一首诗指明他的方向。
没错，我觉得这是一个很有意思的事情，也是一种很好的文化的传承啊。
是的，当然因为时间的关系啊，我们可能要稍作休息。今天我要把 Sora 也留住，还剩十分钟的时间呢。我们回来之后想跟大家来聊一聊，在新西兰或者在奥克兰，我们到底能不能够体验到这样的一个文化呢？
是的， because of the time limits,、yes. but we want to talk more about your culture.
Yeah,
so could you please just
stay
for a little bit longer?
Of course, I love to.
Okay, 所以呢，我们就稍作休息一下啊，回来之后跟大家来说，在新西兰和奥克兰能不能找到这样的一个文化呢？
稍作休息，马上回来。好的，欢迎回来。您正在收看和收听的依然是由 Panda TV 37和 FM 90.6 正在为您同步直播的朝闻天下，我是主持人依然。
大家早上好，我是小娇。我不知道有多少听众观众跟我一样啊，就是那种好奇宝宝。我对于这种新奇，尤其是文化方面，我非常非常好奇。所以我今天呢，本来是安排到45分，就是让 Soraya 接着跟大家来说。So Soraya, we can continue about the things on the table. We have to talk about the mirror.
Yes, and the mirror is a sign of reflection.And we put candles for enlightenment.
Okay.
That is the reason.
Right. And there is one guy must come.
Yes. So when we sit by the table waiting for the arrival of the new year, everyone is in their nice clothes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All the family, young and old, everybody. Usually in the olden days, the father or grandfather had the watch waiting for the...
Exact
New Year
time.
Exact time. And then as soon as it's announced, there is a character called Haji Firuz. And his face is black with like a charcoal color. And he's wearing red. And he sings with a tambourine, saying Haji Firuz Saliye Ruze, meaning that Haji Firuz is here now. Once a year, he comes only once a year to give you the news of the new day, new year.
It's like the Santas, right? Christmas Santas.
Yes, almost. But we've got also a father's, you know, Nowruz, Uncle Nowruz, we call him. Similar. But,
right.
But Haji Firuz is a very, very traditional Persian.
Right. And why his face is black?
Because we believe he was the fire keeper of the Zoroastrian temples, fire temples, and his...face is gone black because of the suit.
Yes. So what he like actually come for? It just bring the news.
The news. He's the news bearer of the new year.
All right. 所以这个也是蛮有趣的、啊、首先要跟大家稍微说一说，在桌子上刚才我们漏了两样东西，一个就是镜子，一个是蜡烛，也
是
他们必放的啊。
没错，那么这个镜子呢，往往啊都是起到一个反射或者说是反映事实的这样一个作用啊。每到其实刚刚就说到啊，每到这个新，我们都说新年的钟声啊，或者说新年的就是据确切的这一刻到来的时候呢，那么家里面比如说是爸爸或者说是祖辈啊，长辈呢就会一起说到说这个新年到来了。然后这个时候就会有一个特殊的人物出场。
这样子我可以让我们导播如果要是可以把、啊、我的这个电脑呢如果打到画面上、大家也许能够看得到，就是一个呢脸上啊就像我们叫中国有点像包公那种全黑，
是的，
然后他穿着红色的衣服会出现，他的作用是什么呢？就是说他啊是其实是代表着意思，就是说呢他会是一个类似像信使，一到每一年只来这么一次，他会是传递新年的信息给所有人。那么至于他脸上为什么是黑的，也是蛮有意思的啊。就说到他呢，其实在波斯的文化当中，相信他们是这种类似于像火的使者。
没错。 是的，所以说在
就是熏黑
也不能这么理解啊。所以说他的这个脸部，这是一种传统的这个风俗啊，所以每到这个时候他会出现。
So next one, what you like eat for food in the New Year day?
I have to also mention that for the New Year, when the New Year arrives, they all their members of the family give their children a banknote from inside their holy book, which is this case is Quran, but you know they can put whatever they like. I believe in, you know, I respect every religion, and so they give that as well as whatever gift they want to give, and then on the eve of the New Year or on the New Year, they have fish, white fish, with herb rice. Persian rice is a little bit different than the Chinese rice. It's a basmati like a more fluffy rice. So and we use a lot of saffron, which is the most expensive spice in the world. I love saffron with rice, and then we mix it with dill, you know, the and I think cilantro, you know, and also some garlic in that rice.
Yes.
And we serve it with that, with saffron and butter and ghee and things.
So is there anything that you can't miss in your like dinner for the New Year? Apart from rice and
fish.
Okay.
Fish and rice. Rice is in every Persian meal.
Right.
Like the Chinese.
Yeah, like the Chinese. It's just we have different kind of rice.
Exactly.
所以啊，也是跟稍微哎，这个也是很像的，就像我们的那个中国会给红包，
对，
对吧？
他们也会给这个，不是红包了，但是是把这个钱啊，会给塞到算是波斯的这种书籍里面，或者说圣经里面。
就是比如说他们有不同的信仰嘛，你只要每个信仰都会有自己的那边，类似于像他信仰的那个圣经，他就会把钱啊夹在这个圣经里面，然后呢，也是有祖辈给他的小孩子。
是的。
就跟我们给红包是一样的，
我觉得他们这种方式其实也更好啊，他是夹在这个书里面，
那是也这红包对吧？就是
也反正就是孩子们嘛，肯定是为了得到这个东西啊。
还有呢，
有
我就问到他说，我说那像我们都会啊，有年夜饭是一定要有这个好好的吃一顿的。那么在波斯文化当中的年夜饭到底是吃什么呢？然后他就提到说有两种东西，就像我们东北人是一定要吃饺子的，他们在波斯文化当中有两种东西是一定要吃到的，一个就是鱼，然后另外一个呢就是米饭。
没错。
那么他们的那个米啊，波斯的米和我们的中国的米有一点点不同，它是更加的 fluffy，
更加蓬松一些，更加暄一些啊，
或者是就是我们可能会比较黏一点，
对，
他们会比较散。
是的，而且他们会在这个米上啊配上其他的一些辣椒呀，比如说大蒜啊、调料啊等等的啊，然后做成这种食物。
好了，还剩下最后啊大概几分钟的时间，我们想说介绍了这么多，我相信大家也很感兴趣，那能不能我们在新西兰也感受一下波斯的文化呢？
是的。 So can we just experience the Persian culture in Auckland?
Maybe Persian food. Is there any restaurants?
Yes, there is a restaurant called Rumi in Parnell. There is also a wonderful shop in Mount Eden called the Caspian. And you can find all of the nice Persian sweets. In fact, this one was flown in from Iran the other day, so it's quite fresh. So they have it, especially now, if you go there, it's...fantastic.
Yeah.
And there is, you know, the Persian breads and all the spices are sold there.
Right.
And I believe there are some poetry groups, but I don't know how, if it's still going on, but if I find it, I'll let you know.
Of course. And also, someone like you have been maybe living Iran for a long time. Are you still celebrating your New Year in New Zealand?
Definitely. Definitely. I have some guests, as well as I'm going to my sister's house for the New Year. And definitely we have to do that, especially for our children and you know, nieces and nephews, to make sure that they carry on the tradition. Sure. Because I believe you have to, you know, be true to yourself. And there is nothing more fake to pretend
to be someone
you are not.
Yes.
It's more beautiful to be just the way you are.
非常感谢啊，今天也是非常感谢 Sorana 也是来到我们的节目当中。不过因为时间的关系啊，我们已经接近了节目的尾声。
是的。
想要了解波斯文化的这边呢，其实有波斯的餐厅，也有呢就类似于像这样的一些小店铺，其实是可以买到他们相关的一些食物的。
没错。那么当然啊，我们也是再次祝这个明天的这个波斯新年啊 Sorana 能够过得开心。Happy Persian New
Year.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.